Hi, in this video, I'll be solving this problem from the Putnam competition this year. The Putnam math competition is a contest for undergraduate students in the US and Canada. Each year it takes place on the first Saturday of December, and it contains 12 problems, 6 in the morning, 3 hours, and 6 in the afternoon, 3 hours, with a 2 hour break in between. I took the Putnam when I was a third year in college, and I solved only a few problems, but even with those few problems, I managed to get the highest score at my college. The following year, I graduated, so I didn't take the Putnam. But that sort of tells me, at least, that the Putnam is very difficult. It's a very hard competition. And each year, when I look at the questions, if I think I can solve a question, then by my standard, that question counts as an easier problem in comparison. This year, I am able to solve this question, so let's go to it. A grasshopper starts at the origin in the coordinate plane and makes a sequence of hops. Each hop has length 5, and after each hop, the grasshopper is at a point whose coordinates are both integers. Thus, there are 12 possible locations for the grasshopper after the first hop. What is the smallest number of hops needed for the grasshopper to reach the point 2021, 2021? Let's strategize first. There's a grasshopper at the origin of the XY plane. And it starts hopping at length of 5, so it could jump to 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 0, 0, 5, -5, 0, down here, 0, -5. And any other possibility in between? Except that it has to land at a point as an integer, at a point whose coordinates are both integers. Are there other points in between where the coordinates are integers? And then you realize that 5, that sounds like a very familiar number. 5 is the hypotenuse of a 3-4-5 triangle. So in addition with the 5 and -5s on the axis, you can also jump to this point here. That's at 4, 3. And that point there at 3, 4. And then on the negative side, in the second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. They say there are 12 possible locations, and those are the 12. And you're trying to reach the point 2021, 2021. So it's way up there somewhere. So way up here somewhere along the 45 degree line is the point 2021, 2021. And we are trying to get from the origin to that point in the smallest number of hops. If you don't know any math, it feels like you should be running along these lines instead of the 5, 5, right? Either the 5 on the X or 5 on the Y, because it's too far away from the diagonal line. You want to stay near the diagonal line. So 4, 3. And actually, if you then followed by 3, 4, then you end up back on the 45 degree line. So it sounds like you should do 4, 3, followed by 3, 4 as a vector. That gets you to 7, 7, which is on the diagonal line. Gut feeling is you should repeat this. You should keep on doing 4, 3, 3, 4, another 4, 3, 3, 4. So you sort of zigzag along here all the way until you're close by, and hopefully you can do some sort of wiggly thing to get to 2021. It's almost like the greedy algorithm in graph theory, where you go the furthest you can at each step and hope that that's the optimal. But we also know from graph theory that the greedy algorithm sometimes is not the most efficient or the most optimal algorithm. So this may or may not be the best way. But so each two steps is equal to 7 in X and 7 in Y. A plus 7 in X and a plus 7 in Y. And we need 2021. So I'm going to take 2021 and divide by 7. Let me do it on the side here, 2021, divided by 7. I learned division differently, so I divide it this way. It's, you know, it's the same thing as this. 2. 8. 8. So it's equal to 288 with a remainder of 5. Oh, that's actually works out nicely. Because that means after running up 288 times, you'll be landing at 2016, 2016. And then from there, just do another 5 and 5. And that'll get you there. So it sounds like it works because there's no step here. There's no step along the way where you were slowing down, except for the very last step. There's no step along the way where you're slowing down or going in the opposite direction of your goal. Your goal is over here. The direction you should go by is that direction. And for every single step, except for the last two, you're going the best you can in that direction. Intuitively, a gut reaction, you're very, very confident that this is an optimal solution. Now, within these steps, you can permute them. You can do one step before another. You can do all the 4, 3 steps first, and then do all the 3, 4, or do the 5 somewhere in between. Yeah, you can mix it up. But basically, this is the basic strategy that's most optimal. All it takes is now to prove that it is, in fact, optimal. Well, here's the proof. The proof is lying right here. The proof is lying in the fact that we think that this is optimal. We think that this is better than the 5 and 5. Why do we think that this is better than the 5 and 5? I mean, they are both Euclidean distance of 5. The distance in the XY coordinate plane is 5, regardless. But somehow we think that this is better. This is better because it brings us closer to the 2021, 2021, or in particular, at each step, it brings us closer to the 45-degree line. So in other words, now we see what's so special about this. What's special about this is that it gives us more X and more Y. It gives us 4X and 3Ys for a total of 7, as opposed to this one, even though the distance, the Euclidean distance is 5, equal distance of 5, it gives us less X and less Y. It gives you 5X and 0Y for a total of only 5. Now we know what the strategy should be. The strategy should be to use the sum of X and Y coordinates. All right, so now we know the strategy. Let's go jump into the solution itself. Let's define the steps. Let 5O to denote the hop from X comma Y to X plus 5 comma Y plus 0. Actually, yeah. Let's A comma B denote the hop from X, Y to X plus A, Y plus B. Then the allowed hops consists of 5, 0, 0, 5, 4, 3, 3, 4, Yeah, let's just put in plus or minus, plus or minus, plus or minus, plus or minus. 0, comma, plus or minus 5, plus or minus 5, comma, 0, plus or minus 4, comma, plus or minus 3, and plus or minus 3, comma, plus or minus 4. Those are all the hops that are allowed, are permissible. At each hop, the total increase in X and Y coordinates is at most 7, with either the 3-4 or the 4-3. The 5-0 and 0-5 only gets you a total increase in X and Y of 5. And all the ones that involve negatives will get you some sort of a negative, so it's not going to be an increase. And we want a total increase in X and Y coordinates of 20, 21 plus 20, 21 equals 40, 42. Therefore, need at least this many hops. There's no way you can have any path that requires less than this many hops. And 4042 divided by 7 is 577.4 something hops. And that means least number of hops is going to be 578. The least number of hops will be 578. So all we need to do is to find a number of hops that is 578. And if we can find that, that will be the minimum, because we just proved that it has to be at least 578. Well, so now let's construct a sequence of 578 hops. Step 1, 4 comma 3. Step 2, 3 comma 4. And then repeat 1 and 2. How many times? We did the division up here. 288 times. Then that'll be total. That'll be 576 hops. That gets us to the point 2016 comma 2016. Just for clarification, these two hops gets us to 7 comma 7 after first hop. So after 288 times, you get 7 times 288 comma 7 times 288, which is 2016 comma 2016. Then hop 5 comma 0 and 0 comma 5 to arrive at 2021 comma 2021 in 578 hops. Since is minimum required, this is the fastest sequence. So the answer is 578. All right, now that I've done this, I'm gonna go back and clean it up a little bit, because I just realized that if I define this notation using parentheses, it's a little bit confusing, because it's the same notation as coordinates, as regular coordinates. So I'm just gonna put arrows on top of it. to denote that it's a jump. Jump, jump. These are jumps. That's a coordinate. These are coordinates. These are jumps. Yep, so that's the solution to this problem. There's actually a name for this approach, an approach where you measure the distance from one point to the next by counting the increase in x coordinate plus the increase in y coordinate. There's a name for it. It's called an L1 norm or a taxi cab distance. Because if you imagine the xy plane as a city grid, then in order to go from one point to the next, you have to go along the city streets and can't just cut across people's homes. It's called the L1 norm or taxi cab distance, and it's a legit mathematical distance, a legitimate measure of distance. So this problem is an application of the taxi cab norm. Well, that's been fun. Thanks for watching. Bye.